Okay, today is March 31st, 2016. This 13-year-old female spade Jack Russell comes in with a big swelling below the left eye. You can see the swelling there. Yeah? Below the left eye, the big swelling. But the right eye? No, they don't have swelling here. Okay. So what is the problem now? What happened is this dog does not have dentist treatment, right? Scaling, nothing, over 13 years?
No, she had before.
When?
Quite long ago.
Hmm. So normally, this is due to the abscess caused by this tooth there. This root, now, the carnation tooth, this root here becomes infected. So it spread, okay. The bacteria spreads upwards to here and causes swelling.
Okay.
Causes swelling, but it has not burst out yet.
Okay.
So we'll extract this tooth and the problem will be solved. Now the other tooth, this one doesn't have the problem. Although it's also full of tartar and bacteria, but there's no infection of the root, so there's no swelling here. Because the root of this tooth is quite close to the sinus, the nose sinus. So that's why the bacteria forms the abscess here. It should be quite painful. But I think you found it early. How long was it?
Yesterday.
You discovered it early. Now,
yeah.
It's such a common condition. Let's show the book here. So you can see there. Exactly this picture here. Let's show the picture. So you hold the dog. So you see the picture here. There is a swelling here. The abscess is from inside here. So it comes out as a swelling. And it's called a carnation tooth abscess. That means a big tooth. This one, which just now I show you. And the bacteria went in and then come out from here. The top of the skin, but this one has not ruptured yet, so there is no hole. If you delay too long, there will be a big hole there. So the treatment is to extract this carnation tooth, and then all the pus and infection will be drained out. So the dog is very old, so there's an anesthetic risk. But normally, I bring the dog here.
Stop.
Not yet. Normally, I check the heart and temperature. The heart is okay. Heart and lungs are okay. Just have a quick check. But it's eating well, right?
Yeah, eating, drinking, everything.
So have a quick check. The heart and lungs are okay. So there's no heart disease in this old dog. Yeah. Quick check. And then the lungs are alright. No coughing?
No.
Vomiting?
No.
No, yeah. So overall, anesthetic should be very little. The risk, maybe about 5%. There's no pain, no diarrhea, right? No diarrhea recently. There's a slight fever, so you will give a drip and antibiotics. Then after that, they will do the extraction today and then it goes home.
Today?
No.
But the extraction, after extraction, can she eat?
Can, but not today, later it is.
Okay.
Other than that, the pulse, the heart and the lungs, abdomen are normal by general examination. So, the only treatment is surgical, there's no such thing as antibiotics. It will not go away, you see. The abscess, no.
Okay.
So you have to decide.
So, but...
What question you want to ask me?
After extract the tooth, any will it affect her in some way, like she cannot eat anything or like hard stuff or any like...
Hard food? Is she eating hard food now?
Yeah, dry she food. Is eating dog food.
Dry one?
Yeah, dry one.
Is she really biting or is she just swallowing?
Biting.
There are other teeth.
She can bite hard stuff.
But some dogs you will notice they don't bite from this side because of this pain. This dog.
Okay.
You observe it because sometimes they only bite from this side because this side there's no abscess. So anyway, the dog can still eat hard food. Only this tooth is extracted and then there's the scaling. Dental scaling, just remove the tartar. Eh?
Okay.
There's some pain, otherwise it does not really like me to open the mouth. You see all inflamed, all red. You know, you see the gums?
Okay.
Okay. As compared to this side. You see this side, the gums are not red. You see that? It's pink.
Okay,
okay, thank you. Okay, thanks, you're finished. So this is the